Here we are at the Alpensia Resort, high in the mountains of PyeongChang, where the first ever Olympic men's big air gold medalist will be crowned on an historic morning for the Winter Olympics and for snowboarding. This is the discipline that's fresh onto the Olympic roster in 2018 and has already produced a gold medal for Anna Gasser in the women's competition. Our finalists come down the slope, hit the jump there, perform their best tricks, make the landing, and then it's all up to the judges. It's an event of thrills and spills and seems an absolutely perfect fit for the Winter Olympic Games. The motto for big air is go big or go home. Dead on zero in terms of the air temperature out there. Ideal conditions, -9 of packed snow out there. As regards the scoring, three scored rounds, one jump per round. The top two scores from opposite rotations are total to produce our medalists. So we're shortly to go away with the first run, and it will be one of the men of the game so far, Red Gerard, to get us underway. Brad, alongside me, big day for big air.
Oh, historic. I mean, you said it best. It's a historic day. First time ever snowboarding big air, making an appearance at the Olympic Winter Games. And you look at the start list that we have, these guys are going to send it today.
Well, these are the men that our starters need to impress. And the judges, very tough job here to rate the tricks. You have to pull out everything you've got here. Three goes at it, and two of them count towards the final score. We saw tension all the way in the women's competition, and we're going to see more of the same here as the men go for glory up in the hills of PyeongChang. So a 49-meter ramp here, in run length of 73 meters, then it's up to the jump, and then it's all about the tricks.
Well, it is all about the tricks, and these guys are going to need to bring their A game, but you say they have three opportunities, but they need to land two of them. That's not a lot of room. You have one mistake, two mistakes, and you're not getting on the podium.
And we saw some surprises earlier in this competition. So no, Marcus Cleveland didn't make the final. That was a shocker. Still a Sambek also, but still a final packed with star quality. Red Gerard, one of the heroes, the slope-style gold medalist. We know Max Perot has the tricks. Just how deep into that bag does he go to pull them all out today?
Well, I mean, if you're going to save him for today, today's the day to bring him out. If you're Max Perot, you have probably the deepest bag of tricks than anyone else in that field. All the guys have big tricks, but when you have three opportunities and you need two of them, you've got to be on point. And I got to think, you really want to land that first run here today, that first jump.
Well, they'll go in reverse order, which means Carlos Garcia, Knight of New Zealand, the top scored rider in qualifying, goes last, and the man who goes first, we've been hearing his name a lot, and no wonder, Red Gerard.
Yes, we have. Well, Red Gerard, 17 years old, one of the youngest ever to win a gold medal, and snowboarding the youngest, and you got to wonder, has that even set in yet on Red Gerard?
Such a laid-back character. Well, they all are, aren't they? But this is a different kind of challenge here. The Olympic spotlight is on them. And a step up, surely, from the pressures of the X Games. This is a discipline that's been going best part of a decade and a half. It's taken that long to get on the Olympic roster. But it's just a great spectacle, isn't it, to see it here in the Winter Games?
Oh, my goodness. Yes, it is. I mean, it's something that needed to happen. The Olympics stepped up, brought it into the Games, and this is bigger than the X Games by far. And Red Gerard, he's a guy who thought X Games was the biggest until he got a gold medal in slopestyle. Red Gerard has changed his tone, and he knows how big the Olympics are. And this could make or break you too as well.
Well, in between this final and his slopestyle gold, his fabulous slopestyle gold. He's been back to the US. He's toured the TV studios. He is taking it all in his stride. He really is. He's, remember, just 17 years of age. Can he do it again? Can he?
Well, you know what? I feel like he's got a really good chance to do it, but I really feel like it's all about that first run. The guys that are going to land their first run, their hardest tricks, but the ones they know they can land, this is so important to get it done in your first run.
Great support for the United States, as there has been throughout the snowboarding competition. They've had a lot to cheer, haven't they?
They sure have.
We've seen Red, of course, win. We've seen Chloe Kim, Jamie Anderson in the women's events, and Sean White, of course, in the half pipe. No surprise to see the stars and stripes flying high at the snowboard venue here in PyeongChang.
But now when it comes to the USA, they are strong, but you always got to feel the Norwegians and the Canadians are stronger when it comes to the big air disciplines. But you know, you look at Red Gerard winning in slopestyle this year at the Olympic Winter Games, and you go back to Sage Kotzenberg winning from the US 4 years ago in Sochi. The USA has got some talent.
So Red Gerard, brilliant run of his life in the third run in the slopestyle, then had to wait until the final four went down. His first run of the final here in big air.
Two, three, four and a half right there, rotations, 16-20 off the bat. Red Gerard coming out swinging on this one.
Well, that's not bad, is it?
Well, and I said that's what you need. If you can get the confidence right there, and Red Gerard having a good spin right there. We'll take a look at the rotations here. He comes in regular foot. There's one spin. Count this one to two, three, four. So four rotations on that. My bad on that. 1440 to start it out. That is the backside 1440 triple cork style right there for him. So he made it look like he had spun the extra 180 on it, but that is definitely the 1440. And I think we're going to see a lot of that. You and I talked about it. Going to see a lot of backside 1440s to start things out.
So first school likely to be headed into the mid-70s, you would think. First runner down here, Red Gerard.
Yeah, not the most technical trick, but should give him a decent score. There you go.
74.75, and that is our first run in the first ever Winter Olympic Big Air Final here at PyeongChang 2018.
So you count the rotations there. That's four full 360s in there that he spun on that one. And then put the landing gear down. Did not touch the snow. That's important. Next up, Billy Morgan.
Crept in through the back door in truth to this final. 28 years of age from Southampton in the UK. Has he got it, though, here to get in amongst the podium positions?
Well, he is a goofy foot rider, so we'll see how he drops in here. Is he going to come and switch? Nope, he's going into his normal stance. Goofy foot rider, here we go, Billy Morgan. One, two, three, four spins right there. That's the 1440. It goes down at the end. Have to take another look at that and see if that was just a little snow snake that got him or what.
Well, Billy, he's absolutely chuffed to be in this final in truth. 10th in the slopestyle final in Sochi. He's blazed a bit of a trail in terms of UK snowboarding, and it's fabulous here to see him in the last 12 in this competition.
You see him get the nose grab in there. And his three upside down spins, 1440, so that is a backside triple cork 1440 with the nose grab to start out this party for Billy Morgan. Now watch the landing here. Oh, it's gonna be up to the judges. Do they dock him for that? Did he land solid? Not quite sure what they're gonna do with this one.
And it's a 30, he's been penalized there, Billy Morgan. But remember, he has two more runs. And of course, the two runs that are scored are the ones that have your tricks in opposite rotations. Third to go, Michael Scherer.
You gotta land it solid, and the judges took points away because he did not completely ride away from that. If he rides away and then has a little problem at the end, that's one thing, but he did not what we call stomp the landing there. So Scherer up next, he's a regular foot rider, so he's coming in switch here, opposite his normal stance. Here comes Scherer. Oh, Scherer goes down on that one.
Not the start he wanted.
No.
Two more stabs at it.
Well, and we talk about the pressure. You have three jumps to land two, and they have to be different spins. And if you don't get that done in the first one, that puts all the pressure on you to land the last two jumps.
Well, Scherer would have been firmly in that category marked outsider ahead of this final. Top seven rider in big air 2017-18. Big improver, but this is a step up that maybe is just a little too hard for him, a little too high. Well, that landing is all important.
It's everything when it comes down to it. You have to be solid. The judges are the best in the world. They travel the world. They travel the world with all these riders, so they know exactly what they can do, and you got to land it solid.
Seb Toots next for Canada. Nose heavy on his landing in the third run in the slope style, having been smooth. He faded out to ninth. He needs a big performance here in the big air.
Well, he is a goofy foot rider. For look for him to drop and switch. He loves the cab spin. So that's when you come and switch and you spin off your heel. So let's see what he does here. Seb Toots, he is known by Sebastien Toutant. He's going to come in switch. So you got to think he's going to go cab here. Spinning that one around both ways. So you see how he lands that. That's the 1440. So we call that a cab. Named after Steve Caballero, skateboarding great. That's where the cab comes from. So you're coming in your opposite stance and you spin off that heel edge.
25 years of age from Quebec, Seb Toots. And he's been on podiums, multiple podiums down the years at the X Games. Gold in 2011 and 2013 in the slopestyle. Silver in the big air in 2011. That's how long he's been making waves in the world of big air.
That looks good. Now you see a little bit of a hand touch right there, just ever so slight. So we'll see what the judges think about that. So it should challenge. I got to think that's going to challenge the scores there. Yeah, there it is, 84-75 into the number one spot for Sebastien Toutant.
To the tune of 10 points there ahead of Red Gerard. 84-75 to Red Gerard, 74-75. So that's laid down a marker from Canada's Sebastien Toutant.
So also remember, that was a cab spin. So now he has to spin in opposite direction from that same way he spun. He has to do it differently.
Well, Chris Corning here in preparation. He's worked on his backside. Come out of nowhere here, just 18 years of age. It's all on this for Chris. Didn't qualify for the slopestyle final.
So he is also a goofy foot rider now, so he'll come in and see how he does. So he's coming in his normal stance right here. Chris Corning, goofy foot. And that's four spins. That's the 1440. Front side 1440 melon. So front side meaning you're spinning off your heel edge, facing the jump. He rotates that all the way around. Four different spins, gets the grab in there. Take another look here. Watch him reach down. That's what the judges are looking for. You see that hand. Reach down. Now hold it through all the spins as long as you can. Watch the landing. Does not touch. Looks close, but does not touch. This should be a decent score for him.
There he goes. Again, that melon grab. That's the front hand.
And so now he's got a front side spin. Now in this competition, you have to spin two different ways. So he cannot spin another front side spin for it to count.
Here's the weight in that landing area. And these moments must feel like hours, actually. Just thinking back to the pictures in the slopestyle with Red Gerard, just watching rider after rider after rider come down and just, oh, hanging on in there. Of course, it all panned out for him in that competition.
Yeah.
So 74-25, and that's a third place provisionally here for Chris Corning.
It's a jump that he can land. It's a frontside 1440. He gets the melon grab in there. He can land that. Judges know he can go bigger than that, but land one, get one under your belt, then you got two opportunities to land your hardest trick.
Togair Bergram, big air bronze in China coming into these Winter Games, could get on the podium. We'll see.
Well, I gotta wonder what he's gonna do. He had the backside 1620 with a mute grab. That netted him a 94-25. Goofy foot rider. So he's coming in his normal stance. Here we go. 4.5 spins. That's a 1620 right there. 1620. Oh, and he feels good right now, because anything above a 1440 on your first run and stomping it, that's 4.5 spins to get that 1620. Got to take another look at this one.
Talking Bergram straight away in this competition. Yeah. Give us a dance.
So that's the backside spin. So that is a backside 1620. This is the one that he got the big score on. But you see the hand touch. Watch this again. It's the hand touch is everything right here. The rotation looks good. The grab looks good. Now watch this. Sets it down. Watch that backhand. Just a little scrape right there.
And in terms of the landing, that's pretty much the sweet spot, isn't it? Halfway down that hill, up and over the knoll. mentioned it, you want as much distance as you possibly get. Of course, the more height, the more amplitude off that jump, the more room you've got in the air to pull out the trick. Straight in first position, Torge Burrum, 88.50, and that is the gauntlet laid firmly down.
Well, and remember what I was talking about. Know a trick that you can do, land it. Judges didn't give him a lot of docking on the points because it was just kind of, it wasn't, he didn't touch the snow to hold himself up. He just kind of brushed the snow.
Kyle Mack, high risk strategy, Japan grab on the triple cork. He's known for adding creativity and putting stylish grabs in there.
Goofy foot rider. Four spins right there, 14.40. You saw the Japan grab, you talked about it. Back double court, 14 on that. I think that was a double. We'll take a look at that again, but a goofy foot rider, Kyle Mack, USA, got an 88.75 doing that in the qualifier.
Pretty good. Pretty good from Kyle Mack, just 20 years of age. And we talked about it off air. It's a young man's game, this, isn't it?
It sure is a young man's game. There's that first rotation. There's the second. There's that Japan as he brings it back. Count them, one, two, there's Japan. Three, four spins down, no hand touch. That's gonna be a big trick. That's just scoring pretty decent. And it goes back to what I was saying too as well. You wanna do something that you know you can land, so you really have the pressure off you and it doesn't push you to have to land your final two jumps.
Yeah, it's all very well having the tricks, but can you fuse that with the strategy? You've gotta put all the elements together go big in big air.
Yeah, so now he's done the backside spin, so he's got to spin a different way.
82 there for Kyle Mack, so that puts him in behind Torge Burrum and Sebastien Toutant. That's some big names still to come. We've still got Max Perot to come down, Carlos Garcia Knight. And next up from Canada is Mark McMorris.
I mean, Mark McMorris nearly died in a backcountry accident just 1 year ago. Collapsed lung, broken ribs. And he's come out and he got the bronze medal in slopestyle. So now he's a 2-time bronze medalist. So I got to think he's putting that behind him now.
Well, we know he's technically accomplished triple cork variations, including the switch backside 16-20.
I would think that he would probably go to a front side triple cork 14 on this one, just to land it and maybe step to the switch backside triple 16-20 that you talk about.
About the Olympic history as well with McMorris. Two bronzes.
Coming in switch here. Oh, and that one gets away with him. So looking like he was going switch back triple 14 on that one. Doesn't look like he was going for the 16, but he was trying to get the switch out of the way. That's going to put pressure on him.
Well, Mark McMorris, no question that he's coming to this big air final as a potential gold medalist.
Oh, 4.5 going 16-20, right. Switch back triple 16-20 he is trying to land. Well, that's the one that got him the 95.75 too as well.
So just to remind you of the mnemonic that the judges are looking at, it is the deal mnemonic.
Yeah, just sets it down. So he takes off switch on that, then lands to his normal stance. So trying to get that out of the way, but that's not gonna help him right there.
45.0. All to do in the final two for Mark McMorris. From Sweden, Nicholas Mattsson now landed a backside 16-20, which is a huge trick. He is capable. 25-year-old from Sundsvall in Sweden. Ninth in the slopestyle, 23rd in that discipline in Sochi 4 years ago. So he has the Olympic experience. He's been there, not quite done it, it has to be said. Best big air, fourth in 2017.
Coming in his regular stance here. One, two, three, 4.5 spins. That's the 16-20, the backside 16-20 mute that you talk about. That got him a 90 before, but falling on that one, that's gonna put all the pressure on, and see him kind of holding that wrist. Gotta hope he is okay, but he went, started grabbing that wrist right away. Take another look here at the spin, there it is. So there's one, there's the second spin, third, four spin, one more around, makes it 4.5 spins, 16-20, back 16-20 with the mute grab, but falls down and you gotta hope he's okay. Let's see what happened to that wrist here on this shot.
Yeah, there'll be some sort of nervy expressions in the Nicholas Mattsson camp there. heavy landing.
Yeah. You see him obviously in pain on that one.
We hope he's okay here. Nicholas Mattsson, 36 is the score. And more importantly, we hope he's fit to continue. Seems to be okay. They're a pretty hardy bunch.
Yeah, when you have a wrist injury right there, that could kind of prevent you from grabbing that board and holding up.
Here comes Jonas Bosica, 22 years of age. Dark horse, Jonas. Qualified third, so he's got the tricks. He's a huge innovator. He's landed tricks that have never been done before, including a quad, underflip, cab, triple cork, 1800. Stomped a pair of frontside triple cork 1440s. So, can he reproduce?
Well, he's a regular foot. Normal stance here. Watch the spin. One, two, three, and a half right there. No, that's the 16. It looks like the spin. Backside triple cork 16. We'll have to take another look at it right there. There's a smile on his face. I think he's feeling pretty good about that one. I mean, just to count the rotations in their spins nowadays is absolutely ridiculous. And judges can actually take a look and have it replayed for them so they can make sure they get it right and see the exact spin done. Here we go. Regular foot. So there's one, two, three, four and a half. Yep, 16-20. Backside triple cork, 16-20.
Jonas, one of the two Swiss finalists here, along with Michael Scherer, who got an 18 score from his first run here. First of three runs in the big air final at the Winter Olympics.
And that's the trick that got him, what was that, a 96 that got him in qualifier. I don't know what he plans for a second one, but this should be a decent score. And I feel like when the judges take their time here, 77.5 into fourth place, so just outside. Something about that that they did not like on that one.
Jorgen Bergeron still leads our big air final here. Sebastien Toutant second, Kyle Mack in third place at the moment. But here's one of the big guys of big air. He's 23 years of age. He's from Canada.
And look where he's starting from. So he's getting up higher to start. So obviously he wants more speed here. So he's got something planned big right now.
Max Perot, the man who innovates. Silver in the slope style event behind Red Gerard. Qualified high for this final. Four golds in big air at the X Games, two silvers, and he's actually made the snowboarding history on four separate occasions. We'll elaborate on that in a bit. Let's watch his first run in this final.
Goofy foot rider, here we go. This is going to be a big one. Four and a half right there, 16-20. Max Perot, solid on his first one. And he's got more in the tank. He's got more tricks than that. He's got a plethora of tricks that he could choose from. Just take your pick. What do you want? So he is a goofy foot rider. So this is a normal stance here. Watch the spins. There's the first rotation. There's one. That's a melon grab. Backside 16-20 triple cork is what he gets there. Oh my goodness.
Max Perot, he was fifth in Sochi in the slope style. That seems to be the progression or the sort of multi-skill set here, slope style and big air for the top snowboarders.
Oh, and see him get a little bit on that edge, but he fought through it. He did not touch the snow.
Surely good enough for the mid-80s here. Currently, Torgeir Bergeron 88.50, Seb Toots 84.75. Max Perot slots in at two. 85 dead here. Solid, solid start for one of the real big favorites here.
Well, I was saying, you know, at the beginning, Canadians and Norwegians are so strong in this. And you look at it, Norway number one, Canada two and three right now after the first jumps.
And it's currently Kyle Mack just on the outside looking in fourth place here. as we come towards our final rider in the first run here, and it is Carlos Garcia Knight. Now, all of a sudden, just in the nick of time in these games, New Zealand suddenly started hitting the podium. Zoe Sadowski-Sinnott bronze in the women's big air here. Nico Portius bronze in the men's free ski half pipe. Garcia Knight, bit of a surprise package. You wouldn't bet against it. This is an event that's tailor-made for potential surprises.
Well, he's got arguably the hardest trick in the bag, a switch backside 16-20. Switch backside spins are the hardest to do in snowboarding. So let's see if he goes for it. Yeah, he's a regular foot, so this is opposite. I think he's going to try it right here. Ooh, deep. See how far he went on that one? All the way past that last blue line.
Well, it's all down. Then to runs two and three for Carlos Garcia Knight, our last starter here.
I'm going to take another look at this one right now. Carlos Garcia Knight dropped the switchback 16-20, got a 97.5, surprised everyone.
Well, you called it, Brad. A case of really nailing that first trick to not put the maximum amount of pressure on yourself for the next two. And the big question mark for you over Carlos, as far as I could gather, was, does he have that second trick?
Yeah, and that's the thing. Everybody knows that he's got a switch backside 16-20. And when you don't land your first one, all the pressure comes on that second and third jump for him. So he's going to get to a situation that at some point, he's got to land the switch backside 16-20 to have a chance to get on that podium.
Carlos Garcia Knight, ninth then at the end of our first run, the first run of three. So it's not game over, not by a long shout. There are two runs still to come in this first ever men's big air final at the Winter Olympic Games. Torgeir Bergram, 88.50. That's half a point better than Max Perrault. Seb Toots third. So Canada, two and three. Norway, top of the pile at present.
Well, I think that the guys who have the advantage are the ones that put up 80s on their first runs. And that's from Kyle Mack in that fourth spot to Sebastien Toutant, Max Perrault, and Torgeir Bergram. All four of those guys have 80s. You know, Jonas Boesinger from Switzerland in fifth, he's not too far out either.
서핑을 접목시킴으로써 눈밭에서 짜릿한 스릴을 만끽할 수 있는 종목으로 자리 잡은 스노우보드는 1998년 동계올림픽 정식 종목으로 채택되었습니다. 오늘날 스노우보드의 훌륭한 선수들은 전 세계에서 배출되고 있습니다. 올림픽 스노우보드 경기는 남녀 각각 5개, 총 10개의 세부 종목으로 구성되어 있습니다. 경기는 모두 다른 종류의 인공 코스에서 진행됩니다. 빅 에어 종목은 2018년 평창 동계올림픽에서 새롭게 선보이는 예정입니다. 선수들은 키커라 불리는 한 개의 큰 점프대 위에서 경기합니다. 올림픽 스노보드 선수들은 경기의 특성에 따라 세 가지 종류의 보드 중 한 가지를 사용합니다. 프리스타일 보드와 알파인 보드, 그리고 스노보드 크로스, 하프파이프, 슬로프 스타일, 빅 에어 선수들은 양방향으로 스노우보드를 타면서 다양한 기술을 구사합니다. 총 100점 만점을 기준으로 넘어지거나 정지 자세 혹은 실책의 경우 만점에서 점수를 제합니다. 심판의 점수 중 최고점과 최저점을 제외한 남는 점수로 순위를 결정합니다. 스노보드는 스케이트보딩, 서핑, 스키로부터 영감을 얻어 다양한 지역에서 스릴 넘치게 펼쳐지는 설상 스포츠입니다. 메달을 획득하기 위해 공중제비, 회전, 비틀기 등 중력을 저항하며 달리는 용감한 선수들 대단하네요.
Make, make, make some
noise! 오빤, 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 오오오오 오빤 강남스타. 보다 야한 여자 그런 감각적인 여자
So we're about to get underway then with the second run of three in this men's big air final at the Alpensia ski jumping facility up in the mountains of PyeongChang. Now then, everyone from Chris Corning upwards has a crack at a different rotation on this next trick. So your two best scores count on different rotations. So there's a lot of variables here.
Well, and that's the important thing to know right now, because Chris Corning, like you said, all the way up to number one, Torger Bergram, they can spin a different way. Now, if they think they can up the score that they have, they can go back to that original trick, like Chris Corning, a 74.25. Maybe he just wants to clean it up and get a big one. But remember, that's going to put your back against the wall. So it is a game plan here. To me, I would think that since you have a full pull on your first jump, that you're going to go to something different with a different spin here. And then maybe, now you have two, you can go back and fix one of them and do it cleaner and do it bigger.
And our five riders that didn't manage to nail that first jump, well, they have to now do it in each of the final two runs. And that bracket includes Carlos Garcia Knight, who came into this final as the top qualifier, the 20-year-old Kiwi. Big pressure now on him. And two jumps left. He has to get both absolutely bang on, and then of course it's in the lap of the gods as we look to the judges to score the tricks.
Yeah, for sure, with Carlos Garcia Knight, but it's a switchback 16 that he has, so no matter what, he still has to try that trick, because that's the one that got him the number one qualifying spot. So when he comes up again, the game plan for him is easy. You need that trick to try and get on the podium.
So here's Red Girard, just 17 years of age, already one of the stars of the games.
Regular foot here, here we go. So the 1080, the front side 1080 for Red Girard. Kind of a mellow trick for him, not something that has a huge degree of difficulty. I mean, you know, that's a 1080. We're seeing 1260s, 1440s, and 1620 attempts out here today. So it shouldn't be a big score. There's the one, two, three spins. Front side, so that's the front side one for him. So maybe that's the game plan for Red Girard at this point. Get your opposite spins, try to make people come out and beat you outright.
Now then, how's Red gonna score in this second round? Not likely to be up there alongside that 74.75 from his first jump here. But Red Girard is a contender.
Well, he spun backside on his first one, then front side on that, so two different spins for him, 65.5. That's not going to get it, but he does have a front side flat 1440, so he could bring that out, add a full rotation to it, and he can get rid of that 65.5.
So that's Red Girard starting us off then in the second round of jumps. Big air final, 65.50 after that 74.75. He's going to need to do something in his third and final jump in this final.
Yeah, and now we look to Billy Morgan, too, the elder statesman, if you will, in this crew.
Well, ever been realistic, really, about what can be achieved here. The 28-year-old from Southampton crept in through the back door to this final and scratched out, really, his first run. 30 points. Needs an improvement.
And there we go right there. That's what he was looking for. Backside triple court, 1440 nose grab. He fell on that. He got the 90.5 in qualifying, and that's the trick he needed. So this could really help him out right now.
Super second jump there from Billy Morgan.
So he's goofy foot. So he comes down with his right foot forward, and he lands with his right foot forward. Take another look here. There's the first spin. Second, three, four. So triple court. Backside triple court 1440 with the nose grab. There's the grab on the nose. Watch the hands carefully on the landing. That's good right there. A little bit of a squirrel out, we'd call that, at the bottom, but should be a good score. He needed it.
He really did. Billy Morgan, 10th in the slopestyle final in Sochi 4 years ago. And it was a bit of a surprise. Eyebrows were raised, actually, to see him on the start list in this final. But Billy, going great for Britain.
Well, he's the first to land a quad backside 1800. Now, everybody's saying this jump is not big enough to do a quad. And that's getting upside down four times. He gets upside down three times in that one with a backside triple court 1440 nose grab.
Wow, 82.50, Billy Morgan. How about that?
Yeah, and that's great, because what that does is erase his first mistake. He landed that. Now he has to come with a different spin for his third and final jump.
Wow, there'll be some trepidation back on the south coast of the United Kingdom after watching that. Billy Morgan has given himself a fighting chance here in the big air final.
Well, his back's against the wall. If he doesn't land that trick, he's done. There's no way he challenges the podium if he does not land that trick right there.
From Switzerland, next down is Michael Scherer. Bottom of the pile in the first jump, down at 18. Big question mark over his genuine chances here of making the podium. Top seven rider in big air this season. Big improvement. But here he is in the final, and much like Billy Morgan before him, has to get a jump here.
Yeah, pressure squarely on his back. He's a regular foot rider. He's got a switch back 1440. Yeah, so he's going to come and switch. He's going to go for that switch back 1440. Here we go. No. Does not go for that. Turns that around to a cab spin. That's when you spin your front way opposite. So he is a regular foot rider coming into it. So we have to take another look at that. I thought he was going to be going switch back 1440 because that's his bread and butter, and that's one of the hardest ways to spin. So this is the cab spin. Watch the rotations there. There's the first one. Nose grab.
altitude. There, he does have to open up a little bit early, but landing it nice and clean, not a hand near the snow. That's one of the criteria judges are looking for, a clean landing.
Super good landing. Two,
times, there you go. He dips his head under his
three and a half, rotation. So the 1260. Cab 1260.
Safe, but is it going to be competitive here?
Well, I mean, you look at his situation too. He fell again on that first run, so he had to have a pull there. He had to land it, so he tried to scale it back a little bit.
And 62.25, so that will be a score jump. Again, it'll come down to his third and final run. So Shera has completed two of his three jumps here in this big air final. And we're going to look now at Seb Toots in 4.75. That was his first score. He now has to try his rotation, his opposite rotation, to get the second score to count here. The five-time medalist at X Games, gold in slopestyle. He's gone silver in big air, bronze in big air as well. He's been doing this for a good old while now. He's one of the elder statesmen. He's experienced in big air. And here he is in the Olympic final. He could get a medal.
Well, he's a goofy foot rider. He had the cab spin on the first one, so let's see what he does here. So he comes in his regular stance here. Here we go, the goofy foot. 4.5, oh, the 16.20. That's gonna be a good score, and he already has one good score. Sebastien Toutant just dropped a solid one on that one.
He really did. That was something, that really was something here. Seb Toots, that's what it's all about. Two jumps so far, and he's absolutely nailed them both.
That's the third rotation. There's the fourth rotation. One more. Count it. 16.20 on that. And that's a flat spin, so he's not getting corked out. Corked out is when they're flipping upside down. So he spins this a flat spin, and it's a different spin than he did before, and he already had a good score. You got to think that this is going to put him to the top.
He's the only third rider in big air history to land it, a triple cork backside 1440. It happened a few years ago. Progression all over the place here in big air.
Well, to me, he's now in the driver's seat because he's already spun both different directions. So whatever is his lower score, that's the one he'll try and erase on his third and final jump. But I got to think he's going to go to the top right now because he's got two opposite spins and he knows it right now.
Yeah, it's just a question of how big this score is going to be. Remember, 84.75 with his first jump, 89.50. Monster score there for Seb Toots.
Well, the judges like that. Some of the judges giving 91s on that. So 89.5 combined with the 84.75, 174 total points from 174.25. Wow.
Now, just to put things in a bit of perspective there, well, that is 34 points better than Red Gerard. Both of those riders have gone twice now. So Seb Toots in the driving seat here in this big air competition. Chris Corning next to go for the United States. He's come from nowhere, the 18-year-old. Didn't qualify for the slopestyle final. Is here and is extremely confident, maybe of troubling the podium. 74.25 in his first run. So the bar has been set by Seb Toots. What can Chris Corning do?
Goofy foot rider, normal stance here. So remember, he had the front side spin on that one. So that one, when they tell you, you got to switch it up. So front side spin on his first jump. So then he takes it, goes to the back side spin to there. So, and he gets that landing too. So it'll be a good score. I don't think it's going to challenge Sebastien Toutant, but let's take a look at the rotations here. So there's his first one right there. There's one, two, three. That is the backside 1440 with the melon grab for that. There's the second, there's the third, count the fourth, boom. So good score for him. At least he has two pulls right now. I don't think he's going to challenge the top, but he'll be up there.
Chris Corning, 74.25 from his first run. And is it good enough to get an 80 here in this second go for the American Chris Corning? Not quite, 78.75. So he slots in second, just behind Seb Toots.
So now, if you're Chris Corning, you're looking at your first score with a 74.25. That was a frontside spin for him on that. So maybe you try to erase that. You try to erase that one and maybe put something up in the high 80s or low 90s.
So Torgeir Bergram, terrific score in his first jump, 88.50. We know he's got it in the locker. How deep does he reach in here? Big air bronze in China. Good build up into these games. Second run in the big air final in the Olympics.
Smooth switch. Three and a half on that. That's the cab spin. So remember, he had the back 16.20 mute, and that got him a huge score, 88.5, near the 90s on that first score. So he had to do a different spin, but with that fall, he's going to have to look to the third one. Let's take another look here. Four and a half on that. So bringing that around, trying to go. Here's another good look at it. The switch front side 1440 is what he's trying to get here.
And then here, spotting his landing. He gets his board around the time, but just maybe the landing a little bit further down than he thought.
Couldn't make the landing.
Unable to stick run number two.
Well, now you know, though, he just needs a different spin. So he's already got an 88.5, so he's still got one more shot. He's not done yet, that's for sure.
This was always a wide open final after our big shocks in qualifying. No, Cleveland, of course. That was a shocker.
Oh, yes. I mean, you always expect Marcus Cleveland. It's a big air final. Marcus Cleveland was supposed to be here, but unfortunately did not make it.
20-year-old Kyle Mack from Detroit, Michigan, Motor Town.
He's goofy foot. He had the backside double cork 1440, put that Japan grab in. We talked about that. So what does he do here? It's got to be different than that backside spin.
Two-time world championship bronze medalist Kyle Mack.
This is his normal stance, goofy foot. Oh, the bloody Dracula he puts in there. And he gets it. The bloody Dracula, we'll take another look at it, but that's when you reach down and grab that tail and you put both hands on it, pull it up tight. It's a trick that he's known for. It's been done in the past, but Kyle Mack's been bringing that one back.
Well, where's the garlic?
He's gonna need the garlic to make it good. One, two, bloody Dracula, three, four. Yeah, that's the 1440. This will be a good score for him right here. And they call it the bloody Dracula because you're pulling the back of your tail so high up tight that if you dig that front side edge, you're going straight to your face, and that's hence the bloody part of it.
82 in the first jump for Kyle Mack. There's so much to admire here. It's such a strong field.
Well, when you're grabbing your board like that, that is not an easy way to grab. You're completely not. Look at the little hand touch there. But you see the reaction from the USA fans on that one.
It's mid-80s, surely. Kyle Mack with his 82. And what happens now? He gets an 86.75. Bang! Straight into second place behind Seb Toots, ahead of Chris Corning. I tell you what, this final run is going to be quite something here.
Well, and for those guys, when you're Sebastien Toutant, you're Kyle Mack, now you can just kind of do whatever you want. Just erase your 82 if you're Kyle Mack, erase your 84.75 if you're Seb Toots.
Now then, Mark McMorris. He's been in the wars in his career, he really has, but he's so technically accomplished. Triple cork variations all over the show. Switch backside 16.20, and he's recovered from his smash up a year ago. 2014 bronze. Behind Ståle Sandbeck and Sage Kostenberg, the surprise gold medalist in the slopestyle in Sochi. Bronze also just a few days ago in the slopestyle competition here in PyeongChang.
He has got to land something right now. Here we go, regular foot, so opposite his normal stance here. Four and a half, ooh, that's going to cost him. After it was 16-20, gets away from him, two falls. You need to land two tricks out of three jumps, and he's not going to challenge the podium.
No, that is a bit of a shocker, to be fair. Two runs in, and Mark McMorris is out of contention. It can happen that quickly. It can run away from you that quickly. It really can.
Well, you and I were talking about the deal is you really want to land that first trick no matter what. You land that first trick, and then you're solid on that, and then you have two chances to land your second trick. Mark McMorris goes down on his first trick. All the pressure was on this one right here for him to land it. He doesn't do it, and no way he can get on the podium now, but he does have that bronze and slope style to look back on.
So even the best, the likes of Mark Morris, can get it wrong in Olympic finals. Didn't land his first jump. From then, the pressure builds and builds. You have to get your next two scores to count. And even the likes of Mark McMorris falter. 45-0, he is out.
Well, just a year ago, they were saying he'd never ride a snowboard again after that huge crash in the backcountry out there in Whistler. But he came back from that, and he's got on the podium. He's a back-to-back bronze medalist in slopestyle, so he can hold his head up high. So when we talk about, when I've heard of the backcountry, he was in the backwoods riding in snow, just doing some powder runs, and he hit a tree. He hit a tree, it collapsed his lung, it broke his ribs, and by that happening to him, right there, people are saying that he'll never ride again. But he's a fighter, he came back, and we see him that he got the bronze medal in slopestyle. So an unfortunate incident, but he looks to be putting that behind him, but a bad turn of events for him today.
From Switzerland, Jonas Bosiger, getting ready to drop.
So, next up, Nicholas Mattsson.
Looks like he is out because remember that wrist thing. So I think Nicholas Mattsson had a problem with that wrist, possibly broken, but he looks like he's not going to be taking a run. So we'll go to our next rider here now.
Yeah, that's a real shame. We do hope Nicholas Mattsson is okay. So his Olympic final is over. So we're going to go now to Jonas Bosiger, 77.50, which not quite up there. Wasn't bad. Needs to be better, though. Run two.
Tried that triple court 14. That gets away from him right there. And riding is on the wall on that one. I mean, look, if he comes out and smashes something in the 90s on his third one, he could come up there, but this is going to be tough for him to challenge the podium now.
Yeah, I think that's knocked his chances on the head. Jonas, junior world champion 4 years ago, and he was very much in that dark horse bracket coming into this final. Qualified third, so we know he's capable.
The 14.40 is the one that gets away from him. Watch it again. I mean, this is all you think he's going to get it here. He gets the mute grab in, holds it all the way to the rotation, and just a little back seat on that one. He's got to sit it down, and that's going to hurt him right there. But still, if he comes out and lands the trick of his life on the third one, maybe he can challenge the top five, but I doubt very seriously with the 77.5 he's going to be able to get to the top three.
Yeah, that second jump score, 36, giving him a total of 113.50, sixth then, and he'll be down the order come the third run. So realistically, that's his chance gone, I think. Now then, Max Perrault, 85 in the first jump, the big innovator. He's landed tricks that some people have never even thought about, let alone attempted.
And he's got the backside triple 16-20. That's the one he landed. So he is a goofy foot. So he has to spin something different than the backside spin. So let's see what he elects to do here. He's got so many tricks. I have no idea what he's thinking about here. So coming in switch here, opposite his stance. Oh, the 18. Cab 1800. Is what he was trying to do. That is five full rotations. You come in switch, you spin off your heel. It's cab, goes to Steve Caballero, who the trick is named after from skateboarding fame. But Max Perrault, if he lands that, that could be 90s, and that could challenge definitely the top spot.
He'll have to throw something down. He jumped three. Well, this event is called Big Air, and there is no doubt there that Max Perrault went big.
One of the most, if not the
Well, you know, a cab 1800 triple cork. So think about it, people. Five spins, five rotations, five 360s, but then three flips in there. So three flips, five rotations. That's an 1800. That's a big trick.
He's great to watch, isn't he? He really is. 117, so sixth. He'll need something special in run three, but he has got it.
But he can go back to that same trick. So if he lands that same trick, that could put him in the 90s. And right there, that definitely could challenge the top for sure. Sebastien Toutant in that top spot, Kyle Mack in second, Chris Corning in third.
So in terms of the strategy, he effectively turns that into a training run, a practice run, I suppose.
And once again, that was the thing I refer to so much. Landing the first trick, that a trick that you know you can land. It needs to be a hard trick, but you know you're confident in it. That way you have two tries to land your hardest trick, which would be that cab 1800.
So we're through the order again on this second run. The men's big air final, we have Carlos Garcia Knight.
Well, we all know what he needs to do. He needs a switch, backside 16-20. That made him the number one qualifier. That's the only way that he gets to the top of that podium, if he lands a switch backside 16-20. But the pressure's on because he needs two.
It's Carlos, he's 20 years of age. He's from Christchurch. Does he have that second trick deep within the locker? We'll soon see.
Here he goes, opposite, he's coming in switch here. Yep, he's going for it.
Oh!
The number one qualifier with the switch backside 16-20, two attempts at it. The hardest way to spin on a snowboard is your switch backside, and that was the one that netted him a near perfect score in qualifier, 97.5, but two opportunities to land it, doesn't get him. He's not going to be on the podium.
Wow. Carlos Garcia Knight in the Olympic final. Just can't quite get up there alongside Zoe Sadowski-Sinnott, bronze medalist for New Zealand in the women's big air competition. Ah, the margins are so, so fine.
It looks like he has it. It looks like he has it. Watch.
I thought he had it.
Watch the landing. I mean, it looks like he's going to roll away from this. Look. And then just a little hand touch, back seat, slides out. Oh, he knows it. Your medal chance is done.
Oh, those are the moments that, he's only human. He's going to replay that over and over and over. So 44 and Carlos Garcia Knight, our top qualified snowboarder here for this big air final, is out of contention.
I will say one thing about Carlos Garcia Knight. He is 20 years old. Look for him to be on his game come Beijing in 4 years.
Well, 5 years his senior, Seb Toots tops our leaderboard ahead of the third and final run. It is now or never for our select band of snowboarders in this big air final. Seb Toots first, Kyle Mack second, Chris Corning third, Red Gerard on the outside looking in as we go into the third and final jump. It all comes down to this, the third and final run in the men's big air final up here at the Alpensia Ski Jumping Facility in PyeongChang. Remember, this is the first time that the big air competition has been included on the Winter Olympic roster, and we are going to see a first ever men's gold medalist crowned very, very shortly. Remember, Anna Gasser has done it in the women's competition for Austria. She was better over those three runs, two scored jumps. The two scores that go towards your final total have to be tricks in different rotations, so it displays variety and it displays consistency. And you just said it, Brad, this is a great format.
It's a great format for sure, but there's no room, there's really only one mistake you can have. And the hard part is you have to land your two biggest tricks because you're competing against the best in the world. You only have room for one mistake.
So we've had two runs already. First to go will be Red Gerard. He won the slope style. It was a nail biter, but he clung on. And in that instant, his life just changed forever, didn't it? He was flown back to the United States. He did the TV interviews. He was in the studios. The lights were on him. Back here. And here he is again in another Olympic final. But in truth, he's struggling here because his scores are not the best. Not the best we've seen in this competition. 74-75, 65-50. So being realistic, you need two scores that count in the 80s, pushing 90 surely. And Red hasn't got it.
I got to think, you know, he does have a... He's a regular foot stance is his stance, so switch back 1260. But the 1260 is not as many rotations as the rest of the guys are getting, but it's switched back, which is the hard way to spin. So the one score, just to really make it easy, he's got to get rid of the 65-5, and he needs to put something up in the 90s to really get up there. Here we go. Regular foot rider, so his normal stance here. Here comes Red Gerard. Four spins, a hand touch on a 1440. Frontside 1440. See, he was trying to actually outdo the one before, so that was a good game plan, but that hand touch might cost him. Taking another look here. Look at the spins. Watch the hand. And getting on that backside edge, too. So frontside 1440 was the idea. I like it because you're trying to get rid of your 65.5. But even if he lands that, I don't think that gets him any higher than upper 70s, maybe low 80s. Maybe it challenges for a bronze medal. But with that hand touch and that little backside squirrel out there going on that edge, watch this right here. So you see the hand touch, and then right there, judges don't want to see that.
So all three Americans in the heats landed backside triple cork 1440s. And there's Red, and what a game he's had already, but that slope style will be his crowning glory here in PyeongChang. Red Gerard out of the medals in the big air, and he's pretty sanguine. He's such a laid-back character. He'll move on. He'll get over this quick enough.
We call that a strong upside. He's 17 years old. You're going to be knowing that name, Red Gerard, for some time to come. He is a pretty cool cat. Good to see him out here competing, and happy that he got that gold medal in slope style.
Well, next up for Great Britain, 28 years of old, years of age from Southampton, world's first quad core, three medals at FIS World Cup events, 10th in the slopestyle event in Sochi. Now then, Billy Morgan has given himself a fighting chance with that second run, 82.50. Boy, this could be something.
Yeah, he's on that higher, he's on the next level up. When you drop in from that higher level, that's going to give you more speed. You got to wonder, is he going to actually try a quad here? He's a goofy foot, so he's coming in. This is normal stance. Here we go. That's four spins right there. That's the 1440. So this will be combined with his 82.5. So you, like you said it, he's got a fighting chance.
That gets rid of the 32.
It sure does. Toss that thing out the window right now.
Yeah. And he'll hope to give this score pride of place on the mantelpiece. 82.50 plus question mark.
Woo.
Yeah. Billy Morgan has pulled it out.
Oh, man. And all the pressure, too. I mean, this is the time. You have one jump to go, and you already have an 82.5. So that was when he landed the backside triple court 1440 with the nose grab. That's where he got that first good score on his second attempt. So he had to do a different spin, and that's why he spun front side on that one. So he had a backside spin that counted, and that's his front side spin right there.
Billy was 10th in the slopestyle final 4 years ago in Sochi. He only crept in through the back door. He was tiptoeing into this final, trying not to wake anyone up upstairs. But here he is. He's making a racket now. This is Billy Morgan.
Well, where does Billy Morgan go? Look, he's getting long in the tooth. He's 28 years old in slopestyle. He'll be 32 in four more years. So you got to think this is his last opportunity. Possibly, I could be wrong, but to get a medal out here in these Olympic Games.
Billy Morgan waits and wonders. Third and final run. This has got to be agony.
So let me remind you, the judges can replay all the hits. So what the judges do now is they really will dissect this thing. They will take a look at every little bit of that jump, the grab, the landing, the takeoff, everything to attach a score to that jump right there. I feel like when they take their time, that's sometimes a good thing.
85 and a half, Billy Morgan, third provisionally in this final round in Big Air, 168, well played, sir.
Well, I'll tell you what, check his fingernails at the end of this competition, because this is going to be a nail biter all the way down to the end, because there's a lot of guys that are below him who already have good jumps so far.
Yeah, he'll be clinging on in there, but he can dream.
Well, we'll look to Michael Scherer, I think, is going to be our next guy. And I think about Michael Scherer. He's already got a cab 1260 nose grab. Well, he will need a different spin.
21 years of age. Top seven rider in Big Air 2017-18. Big improver. Big progression. And that has been the name of the game all over the place in Big Air. Progression.
Yeah, for sure, 100%. But Michael Scherer having a lower score, that 62.25, if he had a 99, I don't think that's going to do it. Switch backside triple cork spin on that one. One of the hardest ones to do. The switch back triple cork 14 is what he's going for. But remember, you're combining it with a 62.25 because he fell on that first jump. So no way he can challenge the podium.
Now, just a reminder that you need, well, higher scores as possible, but the benchmark currently, the late 80s, best score we've seen so far in this Big Air final, Seb Toots is 89 and a half, and you need two scores of something approaching that, really, to get the gold.
Well, there is the switch backside 1440. He did that in qualifiers. It got him an 87, so that's probably right around the number you'll see. That's a great stomp. Bolts right there on the landing. But see the grab, though. You see his arm go underneath that thigh. Judges want to see you hold that grab. So they might dock him on that one. This should not be a very big score.
So the 62.25 combined with the numbers you're about to see on your screen, and that will be the final reckoning for Michael Scherer. But we've said it a good deal in this competition. He's such a youngster, Scherer, 21, and he'll be back.
Yeah, for sure. You feel like upper 20s is about the distance when it comes to slopestyle.
78.50, more than respectable, but unfortunately it's not up there. It's not quite good enough in the Olympic final. 147.5, and he'll finish down the order.
Got to bring your A game when you're competing against the best in the world, that's for sure.
Well, next down is currently the main man, Seb Toots. How does he replace the 84.75? That's his big question. Biggest score of the day, and he is in control of this competition currently.
Yes, he is. And if he puts something in the 90s to replace that 84.75, he's almost a lock for a medal. Don't know what color that medal is, but he's pretty much a lock for a medal if he can get rid of that 84.75.
Five times a medalist at the X Games, gold, silver in Big Air and slopestyle. But this is an Olympic final, and it is the third run of that final. Here's Seb Toots for Canada.
Coming in switch here. Four and a half, the 16.20 right there. So he's just got to keep the scores. I like what he was trying there. Trying to bring that around to a 16.20, four and a half rotations for the goofy foot rider, Sebastien Toutant from Canada. Oh, he knows it. And just, oh. So that's the cab spin right there. Yeah, going straight up, cab 16.20 gets away from him.
It's going to be those first two scores that combine for the total for Seb Toots in this final, 174.25. after that jump not scored, third run down. So provisionally top, 17425, but the window is open here for someone else.
But someone's got to come out and just outright beat you is what's going to happen right now, because you already got the 89.5, 84.75. So somebody who already has mid-80s put up a 90s, they could challenge that.
So the two scores so far for Chris Corning, next down 74.25, 78.75. So he's got to scratch out that first run.
Here's the game plan for Chris Corning. Land the biggest trick of your life right now on your third jump to try and crack a podium position. That's what he needs to do. He needs to get rid of the 74.25. That was his first jump that he had. He needs to smash one in the 90s right now. Only way to have a chance.
Already an upgrade from his slopestyle performance where he didn't qualify for the final in that one. He's just 18, Chris. Bronze in the slopestyle at the World Champs last year, Sierra Nevada. Fifth at the X Games in Big Air last month. He wants to up his level. Sixth in the slopestyle, so essentially on the outside looking in. And that's been the case for him so far in this Olympic final. But a big score, and it all changes again.
Well, goofy foot rider, so let's keep this in mind, what he's going to do here. So that's normally right foot forward. So he's coming in his normal stance here. Needs the biggest trick of his life. No big deal. Here we go. Five, going for the 1800. Oh my gosh. Quad cork 1800. Everybody was talking about, would we even see an attempt at a quad? Chris Corning was trying to take that one to the top right there.
1800, five spins, a monster move.
And, no, not just five spins, but four flips in there. So four flips, five spins, he was going for it. But that's what I said. Simple game plan. Chris Corning, do the hardest trick of your entire life. Take a look, here it is. One, two, three, four, five, quad 1800, backside quad 1800. That is absolutely ridiculous. That's the progression that we talk about, and Chris Corning trying to lead the edge right there in progression with that big one.
So that'll leave him with his total for the first two jumps. Oh, agony as you just, oh, there's just such trepidation as you follow that jump down, and but is it gonna land? No, there.
Just a little bit on that heel edge, just a game of millimeters on that one.
Outside the medals, Chris Corning here, but what a tryer. 153 in the end for Chris Corning of the United States.
18 years old, 2 years ago, you didn't even know who this guy was, and he comes out, he makes the Olympic team for the USA, and things are looking bright for the 18-year-old. He's gonna be solid in the future.
So Seb Toots remains in the lead. Kyle Mack, the only American in our final here who can now get a medal. And here we go with Torge Bergram. 88.50 was his first score, so he'll be trying to scratch out that 42.5 from run two. We know he can do it. Big Air bronze medalist in China, so good form coming into these games. Could get on the podium, just get something in the 90s. That's the challenge you set yourself.
My goodness, he already has the back 16.20 mute. That's what he has, so how's he going to replace that? Goofy foot rider coming in switch. Here we go, Torge. Oh, the cab spin on the 14. That's not going to do it right there. And that's a shame because he already had the 88.5. So he was already close to Sebastien Toutant's top score. Oh, heartbreak for Torger.
It really is. Final run of the day in the Olympic final.
Watch the rotations here. Yeah, you see how he opens up. When they open up, that means they're not happy with the spin. They're trying to stop rotations. He tries to open up a little bit right here just to slow it down. Oh, all the pressure in the world was on his shoulders right there, especially when you already delivered on your first jump with an 88.5.
Yep. And then the 42, and then the no-score jump. So Torge fades, I'm afraid. He will be nowhere near the podium, but again, take a bow for trying it. 131 for Torge Bergram.
Boy, that definitely frustrated, especially when you put up on your first jump 88.5. You think that you're in the driver's seat, you're Norwegian, you're great at what you do, and not able to put it down. Now we look to our next rider here.
Now then, Kyle Mack in the silver medal position currently. Japan grab on the triple cork. It's a high-risk strategy, known for adding creativity and putting the stylish grabs in there. We know he can do it. Didn't qualify for the slope style final. It's already an upgrade here, but he has hopes of a medal.
I don't even know what he's going to do right here, because you're Kyle Mack, you're trying to lose the 82. The 82 was a backside double cork 1440 with a Japan grab. So you have to be better than that. Okay, maybe the plan here is do the biggest jump of your life right here.
Well, I love this. He missed qualifying for Sochi 4 years ago, so his dad built a training area for him near his home. There's an airbag as well for summer training. Is it worth the effort? Kyle Mack.
So close on that one for Kyle Mack.
It's a no score all of a sudden in jump three. So 82 and 86.75. 168.75. No, it's not going to be a gold medal for him.
It's not going to be a gold. Let's watch this rotations here. So there's one, there's two, there's three, there's four and a half. So he's going for the 16.20. And you know what? That's what you do. You go for the biggest trick that you got. So the game plan was correct. It's a Japan grab. He did the backside double cork 1440 Japan. So he was just trying to turn the 1440 into a 1620. And that would have replaced it. That was a good game plan, because the 82 is what he got. So add a 180 to it. What does that give you? Maybe up in that mid 80s, but be tough. He's in silver medal spot right now, though, for Kyle Mack.
Yeah, he's coming short. Well, the best part of 6 points there behind Sebastien Toutant, who remains our leader, and indeed take a bow. Kyle Mack, silver medal at present. But we have more jumpers, 4 of them indeed, if Nicholas Mattsson decides not to run again. Our Swedish competitor, who injured his wrist by the looks of things in his heavy landing in that first run. So Seb Toots 1, Kyle Mack 2, Billy Morgan staying there in third place, clinging to the podium currently for Great Britain. But here comes Mark McMorris.
Yeah, but what do you do if you're Mark McMorris? There's no way to get a medal. Do you risk one of your biggest tricks just to show you can land it? Or do you do something super stylish for snowboarding?
This man has 2 bronze medals at Olympic Games in the slope style, but it's not happened for him in this final.
Big method air right there. That is proper right there. Your regular foot rider come in. The method air goes back to Neil Blender, 1985, a skateboarder who did it back then, and it was named the method air. Then we saw guys like TJ Hawkinson doing it, Terry Kidwell doing it, Jamie Lynn doing it. So it is this one of the most stylish things you can do with snowboarding, but it gets you absolutely no points.
Well, the campaign had ended before this third and final run, so Mark just enjoying his last time on this Olympic jump, third and final run for Mark McMorris. Big favorite, double Olympic medalist already in snowboarding, but just a competition too far for him here.
But the great thing about this, that's for snowboarding right there. That's not going to get you the score, but he's doing it as a tribute to snowboarding, coming out and doing the method. It's one of the most old school snowboarding tricks, and if it's done right, it looks stylish, just like Mark McMorris right there.
On we go with Jonas Bosiger. So Nicholas Mattsson's competition is over. Confirmation of that. Now then, Jonas Bosiger, 77.50 and a 36. Yeah, I mean, he'll look to go out on a high, but he's not going to get a medal.
Well, one of the things here, if you're Jonas, once again, try the biggest trick of your life right now. Jonas is 77.5. So if he did put something, look, if he went up to mid-90s or upper 90s, well, then he could challenge. He could definitely challenge, but you would need like a 98, 99 or something like that. There's the Swiss flag flying. And even that probably takes you out. But 77.5, obviously, he's got to do something better than that 36. What do you do here? So he's a regular foot rider. So his normal stance right now. Here we go. Frontside triple cork 14 slides out, and I don't think that would have got him up there, but it would have moved him up the list, that's for sure.
Well, he'll have loved his experience. 22 years of age, Jonas qualified third, so we knew he'd got the tricks there, but again, coming into this final, the exalted level, he's not quite been up to it, but terrific again from Jonas. 47.5 plus his 77.5. So that second jump not scored. He'll finish down the order, 118.25. Bold attempt.
You know, you got to give it up for him. He was definitely going for everything he could do right there. But not, and you see him get on that toe edge right there, and just cannot get his body weight back over the board. So that's not going to do it for him. He is done in eighth.
Well, some that have completed their campaigns, just the pressure is off, and we see the smile a little wider. Now then, hold your breath, everyone. Max Perrault, this is going to be massive. 85, and he's 32, so he needs to make a jump here to push Billy Morgan off the podium.
You got to think he wants the 1800 spin here. He wants to go five rotations on this. Kyle Max guaranteed a medal. Whether it's going to be bronze or silver, that's going to be up to Max Perrault right now. So the U.S., Kyle Max will come away with a medal out here today, and so will Sebastien Toutant.
Mr. Innovation in Big Air landed tricks that had never been done before. A quad underflip, cap, triple cork, 1800, stomped a pair of frontside triple cork, 1440s in qualifying. Max Perrault, can he become the main man here with his third and final jump in the Big Air final?
So coming in switch, here we go, Max Perrault.
No! Max Perrault! Oh, wow!
Congratulations right there. It is set. There is no way with Carlos Garcia Knight coming up last. He's already had a problem and a 44, so that means Sebastien Toutant's going to come away with the gold. Kyle Max going to get a silver, and Billy Morgan's going to come away with the bronze.
Well, Max Perrault, stunning, 85, and he's 32, missing that second jump, put all the pressure on this, and it must have felt like all the pressure in the world. He comes down heavy, crashes out.
Yeah, and he is a goofy foot too, so he was coming in just trying to put whatever he could down, trying to get 1800, that's what, and he's got the bag of tricks, but when you don't land it, that's just the unfortunate situation there.
Oh. So that's a real story. Max Perrault, silver in the slopestyle behind Red Gerard. Max Perrault finishes way down the order, and your ears are not deceiving you. Billy Morgan will win a snowboarding medal for Great Britain. So we have Carlos Garcia Knight to come down, but that won't impact at all because he's had a JNS and a 44. He can do nothing.
Yeah, so his run not scored in that first one for Carlos. He gets the 44 in the second one. So whatever he does here cannot challenge the top. So the top three are set. Sebastien Toutant with the gold medal. Kyle Mack from the USA with that silver. Billy Morgan. You got to think possibly his last Winter Olympic Games, Billy Morgan come up with a bronze no matter what. So does Carlos Garcia Knight still go for the switch backside 16-20? Does he do it here? I almost think he does because he didn't land it. Here we go. So he's coming in switch, so maybe he's going to try it. Let's see. No. It's just solid stuff. So smooth. Carlos Garcia Knight. Just having a good one. He knew it was out of touch right there, and there's no reason to risk it right there because you're not going to get a medal today.
Just a nice slow one for the photographers, really. So that is that for the Big Air final. It has been an absolute thriller. What a morning we've had. Remember, this is the first ever final of the Big Air competition on the Winter Olympic program, and we have a Canadian gold medalist. We have the United States on the podium, and we have Billy Morgan bringing home the bacon, bringing home the bronze for Great Britain. But Seb Toots, highest score of the day, and that's fitting that he has won the gold medal. But we wait here to see Carlos Garcia Knight score, just 20 years of age. And it's in the mid-50s there, 54.25. So the top qualifier finishes in penultimate place in the final. That was heart-stopping.
Yeah, you really got a feel for Billy Morgan. You really got a feel for Sebastien Toutant. Look, Sebastien Toutant is 25. Add four more years to that when Beijing happens. That puts him at 29 years old. That's about where you're going to be. You don't see, there's not one competitive slope-style big air rider that's in the 30s. And when you're approaching that, this is a big win for Seb Toots right here.
Well, we talked about the strategy earlier, Brad, and you have to say Seb Toots got it right. He nailed that first jump. Okay, he bettered it second time round, but that meant when it came down to the third jump, he didn't absolutely have to do it.
Yeah, and that's the pressure thing. That's by landing his first jump, then switching up the rotation and landing his second jump almost in the 90s. That took all the pressure off his back because someone out was going to have to come outright and take him down. And he didn't land his third jump, but it didn't matter when you land your first two.
Seb Toots is the gold medalist in men's big air at PyeongChang 2018. I make that Canada's 11th gold of the games. Kyle Mack for the United States, highest placed American. Chris Corning and Red Gerard, fourth and fifth. One of the big stories here, well, there's two of them actually for Canada, Max Perreault and Mark McMorris, nowhere.
Yeah, not gonna see that. You know, you don't see that happen very often because Max Perreault is a dominator when it comes to big air. He's a guy that you always expect to see on the podium. And when he landed the first run and got the 85, I thought, uh-oh, look out, Max is gonna make something happen in a big way. And he went for it, but the progression of snowboarding is so big now, and the level of the tricks that are being thrown down is so tough that just one little bit off, you can't land the trick. And we saw that. We saw trouble with Mark McMorris on two of those jumps having trouble. We saw Max having trouble on two as well.
A thrilling final in the men's big air. Seb Toots walks away with the gold medal. Kyle Mack, silver for the United States. From Britain, Billy Morgan with the bronze. So, Max Perreault and Mark McMorris, 9th and 10th respectively. Carlos Garcia Knight couldn't bring it when it mattered most here in the Olympic final. Torge Bergram as well finishes in 7th place. So we have three different nations on the podium. And it won't be too long before we see the venue ceremony here.
And you look at Mark McMorris, 24 years old. He'll be back definitely in another Olympic Winter Games. Max Perreault for sure, 23 years old. He's the guy that will be back. But you got to feel pretty good for Billy Morgan.
So this is the scene up in the hills of PyeongChang at the Alpensia Ski Jumping Centre. A fabulous competition in the men's big air. And it's safe to say this addition to the Olympic roster has been such a hit. Seb Toots has won the gold medal. Kyle Mack, silver. Billy Morgan for Great Britain. And we're just waiting now for the venue ceremony. The medals to our 1, 2, and 3 place finishers will be awarded later at the medals plaza, but this is the venue ceremony coming up in just a few moments' time.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie
so,
du snowboard.
We're ready then for the venue ceremony at the end of a thrilling, a heart-stopping final of the men's big air here at PyeongChang 2018. Seb Toots held on to top spot. He is our gold medalist from Canada. The United States silver medal with Kyle Mack and Billy Morgan for Great Britain steps onto that third step of the podium with the bronze medal.
You gotta like the stories that come out of this one. Sebastien Toutant from Canada, 25 years old. 4 years from now, he's gonna be up there a little bit. So seeing him get the gold, that's a great story. Kyle Mack, 20 years old for the US, coming out here in his first ever Olympics, snagging a silver medal. And Billy Morgan, the oldest competitor in the field at 28, getting a bronze.
Les présents seront remis par Monsieur Dexter Payne, États-Unis d'Amérique, vice-président de la Fédération Internationale de Ski.
The gifts will be presented by Dexter Payne from the United States of America, Vice President of the FIS.
So, Dexter Payne, Vice President of the FIS, will present not the medals, but the gifts that are handed out in the venue ceremony. Our podium finishers will be awarded their medals at a later juncture. Absolutely fabulous for Billy Morgan. Great Britain get another bronze. I make that bronze number four in these games. It's been a stunning couple of weeks for Team GB, as they're known in PyeongChang. Billy Morgan at age 28 has stunned us all, I think, by getting on the podium.
Yeah, him qualifying was a stunner right there for him to get in, but then to come away with a medal, competing against Max Perot, Mark McMorris, Kyle Mack, Sebastien Toutant, Chris Coy, I mean, the list goes on. But he's the guy on the podium in that bronze.
Silver medal for the United States, finishing ahead of Chris Corning, who was fourth. Red Girard, the slopestyle champion, finished fifth. But Kyle Mack, at age 20, has an Olympic silver medal.
Watch this kid grow, announcing his snowboard runs so many years ago, and he was probably about 4 feet tall. And now he's 10 feet tall on top of that podium with that silver medal for Team USA today.
US with gold in the half pipe, Sean White and Red Girard in the slope style. It's for silver here in the big air for Kyle Mack. We always knew the US would be strong across the board, a deep bench, as they say in basketball, and they've proved it here.
Well,
you talk about the deep bench. Canada, a very deep bench when it comes to slope style. Sebastien Toutant, a feel-good story. This guy at 25 years old, snagging the gold medal. The talk is always about Mark McMorris, Max Perot, Mark McMorris, Max Perot, but today the talk is about Sebastien Toutant.
Biggest score of the day, and of course that helped him. The second jump, 89.50 with his 84.75. Pretty good. Pretty good. It's gold medal good here for Seb Toots of Canada.
That's amazing stuff. You know, the talk about it, it's always Canada, it's always Norway, but you see USA sneaking in there. They have a young group of guys, so I got a feel we're going to be talking about Canada, Norway, and the USA when it comes to big air for a very long time.
Yeah, they'll be talking about these big air finals for a long while as well. Seb Toots is the gold medalist in the men's. He joins Anna Gasser, and these are genuine Olympic trailblazers. First time this discipline, the big air, has been on the Olympic program. It's kind of got a history dating back 15 years, but big air is here to stay. Thrills and spills. And we have a gold medalist from Canada. Seb Toots did the business.